he is the chair of the Toulouse Gerontopole Center, and he has received numerous distinctions along his career, particularly from the French government. So he's been awarded Chevalier dans les Ordres de Pan Académique. Andrei Rachevsky can correct me if I'm pronounced wrong. And in three times at least, he has a lot of support, a grant support. What is very important and very interesting about him, he's about to reach 1,000 publications already. And he is part of the World Health Organization Advisory Committee for Health Research. And so he has been involved in initiatives at the World Health Organization, which are directed to healthy aging. And particularly, he's going to talk today about one of those initiatives that he's leading, that is the INSPIRE project, that is a 10-year grant that started recently. And what is very relevant for GIRO, it is that the INSPIRE program is going to pursue a cohort study that it's going to include 1,000 participants, and probably Bruno is going to talk about that today. And for that reason, so it's going to be very, very good for our own cohort study, just to learn more about other experiences as the INSPIRE project. So thank you very much, Bruno, for joining us today. And we're very excited to hear you.
Okay, thank you. I am very happy to be with you. I need to use my screen. You see the slide?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah. Okay. I am very happy to speak to you about the INSPIRE Bioresource Research Platform for Healthy Aging and Geroscience. And I am especially happy to be with you. Felipe Sierra, that joined our team, spoke a lot about you. And I remember that I went in Chile, it was maybe, I don't know exactly, between 10 and 20 years ago. And I have a very good souvenir about that thing. The rationale of the INSPIRE study is that clinical care and research strategy are disease-centered and not adapted to an aging society. The result is the increase of dependent older adults. For the WHO, healthy aging is the ability to do what we value and to maintain function. Aging is a major risk factor for the development of age-related disease or functional decline in intrinsic capacity, which determine healthy aging. Chronological age, as you know, differs from biological aging. And our aim is to define biological aging and identifying targetable biomarkers is an essential step to understand links between aging and related disease and loss of function. And by geroscience, we can expect by manipulating aging, if it's possible, probably, to delay onset and to reduce the severity of age-related chronic disease. With the usual aging, we have this kind of loss of intrinsic capacity. And when we lose intrinsic capacity, we finally lose function. Our aim is to increase the intrinsic capacity to be able to maintain function. And it's much better to be at 70, 75 years old here, like here, where the people come independent. For that, we plan to increase and maintain reserve in early aging, maintain and slow down the decline of in late aging, validate biovisual, digital, and blood biological age biomarker, and validate regenerative medicine and also rejuvenation therapy. The global aim is to build a comprehensive translational platform on geroscience to reduce functional loss and dependency with aging by a biological-based project transnationally connected to the clinic. Our specific aims are to build the INSPIRE animal aging and translational human cohort, to gather biospecimens of different age and functional capacity level, from robust to frail to disabled, longitudinally. To identify basic biological mechanisms of aging, targeting stroma, immunity, and metabolism, to validate biological edge, slow accelerated aging, and delay age-related disease. To implement the ICOP WHO program in Occitania with the Inspire Clinical Care Cohort to adapt already now our healthcare system to aging with an integrated and function-oriented clinical care pathway consistent with the WHO concept of healthy aging by maintaining function to be able to do what we value. To develop digital health with the Inspire Digital Cohort and to start RCT to delay age-related disease. For that, for the platform, we will work and we'll see some more in detail on animal cohort to understand them better some mechanism of aging. We will focus on mitochondria. We will have the Inspire Translational Clinical Cohort that are in human and care cohort. We have a digital care cohort from ICOP. We have also some health economic aspect, and we have a CART e-program that use a new technology. We have one important international education program with a PhD course on aging and with the ERP program, what they call École Universitaire de Recherche, that was financed. We got few, 3 million euros to build this program educational. And finally, we build a large biocampus dedicated to healthy aging in Toulouse area. For the Inspire Human Tech Cohort, is a population of 1,000 people from 20 to more than 100 years old, from robust to frail. We exclude those that have a severe disease, and we plan to follow them for 10 years. You can see they have the baseline, and we use ICOP Digital also to look at loss of interest and capacity in this population, and some people have some kind of interest and capacity problem. We do a new assessment in the lab where we plan to look also on resilience. And we do that each year and for a 10-year period. That is some of the clinical data that we collect with the frailty phenotype, functional status, cognitive status, physical performance, depressive symptoms, nutritional status, oral status, promise, vision assessment, and the ICOP monitor apps, that is really important. And we look also at new diagnosis, COVID, etc. We do some imaging in a subgroup when we look at VOD match, we look at some body composition, we do some brain, brain MRI. We have the Inspire cohort that is looking at some sensor, automatic sensor in the home of 100 of the participants to have more specific biomarkers that we hope to develop in the future and that we can compare to others. For the biospecimen at baseline and every year we have blood where we look at PBMC, we have urine, we have saliva, we have dental plaque, we have a skin biopsy in a subsample hair bulb, we have the feces to work on the microbiota, and we do that every 2 years. We have also nasopharyngeal swab and skin swab and stripping in this cohort population, as you can see here. For the mouse cohort is a cohort of 1,460 mouse, outbred Swiss derived mice from male or female. And we do some assessment at 6 months, at 12 months, at 18 months, at 24 months. We have a group with a normal and a group with a height diet, fat diet. And we look at functional phenotype with body weight, motor coordination. We have some kind of automatic system. We lose at grip strength, and we do also a lot of blood sample. We look already at some biomarker. We have a tissue bank of all of the people that will have all of these animals that will have one autopsy too. That is the resource that we have available. And with this kind of resource that we have available, we have the research team that work on specific program. We have a specific program on mitochondria. We have one important platform to work on mitochondria in Toulouse, biological platform. And the aim is to look at some blood biomarker to be able to measure the mitochondria status in human only with the blood. And after that, we plan to do some clinical trial targeting those that have not good mitochondrial function and to be able to see what we can do with some kind of gyroprotector. And after that, we can look at gyroprotector and do this kind of RCT on mitochondria to maintain function and to maintain mobility. We have also some study on senescent cells. We had a cohort of older people with a cancer, and we plan to compare this population with a control cohort and to have a focus on senescent cells. We are working on that on some labs in Toulouse that are part of ESPAN. We are also working on the immune system deeply with the Infinity Group, and mostly on the link between skin and general immune system. Maybe one hypothesis of this group is that skin biomarker could be good biomarker to assess biological age. We have also some program, as you know, we have now some blood biomarkers that are validated for Alzheimer's disease, like a phospho-tau-217, and we are working how we can use this blood biomarker in clinic, but also in the ESPART cohort, we plan to do some correlation between this neurodegenerative biomarker and the biomarker of aging to see if we can correlate cell senescence, if we can correlate mitochondrial function at the human level with the production of this blood biomarker. We have some study on microbiote. As you know, we have some feces part of the biospecimen to work on chance of microbiote with aging and the correlation with cognition. Some of our participants had COVID, and we are working at the immune response after COVID, after the vaccination, and some have long COVID that we are planning to assess deeper. We have also one artificial intelligence program in Toulouse. It's a big calcul institute with a big program on artificial intelligence. And one of our topics is to try to better understand the result that we have in animals model to be able to translate it into clinical research. As one of our specificities in Toulouse is to do randomized controlled trial to work on drug development. And sometimes we have some study in animals, but if we want to do prevention of aging and age-related disease, we need a much longer period in human. And the idea is to try to calculate how we can translate the results that we have in human, in animal to human. That is some example we can do deeper if you want after. Now we are regrouping all these labs that are working on aging, part of the ESPART program, labs that work on mathematics, labs that work on new technology, on economics, and the labs that work here in the MC that work on metabolism, the CPTP that work on inflammation, the UMR 1027 that work on epidemiology and method for randomized controlled trial. With the GenoTools, that is most of the platform that we have in Toulouse. We have a lot of platform in Toulouse. And here, some industry in Toulouse, we have large industry, pharma, but we have also Thales, we have Airbus, the site of is in Toulouse. And we are planning to build a building, a geroscience building in the bio campus here in Toulouse. I would like to focus now a little bit about our program that is integrated care older person, ICOP WHO program. And the idea is to do some translational research between geroscience and the loss of intrinsic capacity. For the World Health Organization, healthy aging is not a life without disease. We can have disease at any age, but it is a life when you are not able to maintain your function, to be able to continue to do what you value. That is really important. The senior citizens, they want to be able to continue to do what they value. And the WHO identifies six functions that we need to maintain. These functions are memory, mobility, vision, hearing, mood, and nutrition. As you can see, we are changing from a disease-oriented research from a function-oriented research. That is one of our specificities in Toulouse. With the WHO, we validated a screening tool to assess this intrinsic capacity in primary care. And this program is now recommended to all countries by WHO, but we need to have data on that. That is a WHO ICOP screening tool. You can see we have a very simple question to assess, for example, cognitive decline. We ask to the people to remember three words from the MMSE that we recall after. We ask some question of orientation, time orientation. We ask also if the subject has kind of subjective decline. We look at mobility with shared rise test in less than 14 seconds. We look at nutrition with weight loss, loss of appetite. We look at visual, if the people have visual program and progression, the same for hearing loss. And we look also at mood, if the subject feel to be depressed, little interest or pleasure in doing things. All of these questions have been very well validated by the WHO, and it is important because when some people have no abnormality, we don't need to do deeper, everything will be fine. But when they have some kind of abnormality, it's important to try to understand why and to intervene as soon as possible. That is the WHO program with step one, that is screening. Step two, that is the assessment of the function. Step three is the care plan. Step four is the monitoring. And the step five is engaging community and supporting caregivers. We need to have one ecosystem that is favorable. And the aim of the WHO is to prevent the number of dependent people by 15 million by 2025. That means, for example, for France, if we consider that we are 1% of the senior citizens, it would be 150,000 subjects that we can prevent. As you can see, ICOP WHO aims is to decline by 15 million the number of dependent older persons by 2025, implement the ICOP WHO program in Occitania to adapt our healthcare system to aging by a function-oriented clinical care pathway, including digital health. And the objective is to follow 200,000 subjects by 2025 in Occitania region. What will be good, all these subjects, we have found that 75% of the subjects are okay to go to volunteer for clinical research, and we will have all the subjects that we need. That is how works the system. We have the app, everything is free. That is ICOP monitor that people can download from their cell phone, or we have a vocal robot people can find on internet. We look at if everything is normal. We learn to the people how to do assessment again 6 months after. And if sometimes is abnormal, all the data go on the frailty secure database. We have a tele-nurse that look at the database. If they find that something is going wrong, they call the subject to be sure that is really abnormal. And if so, they call the general practitioner. For example, if some people had weight loss, they call the subject to measure again weight, to be sure they have weight loss, and if so, they call the general practitioner to try to intervene as soon as possible. That is a digital program, and I will show you here. You can see the nurse. They follow the patient. They look here, this guy is normal for cognition. He have some loss of nutrition that is new. When he's red, he's new. When he's green, is something that is becoming better. That can appear that we have some people that have weight loss, but after they have normal weight loss, they can recuperate. And for that, we have the telenurse that look at the subject. And as you show you here, that now we follow 7,586 senior citizens. We have started this program only late May 2021. In 1 year, we plan to follow 10,000 subjects. It's working very well. The mean age is around 70-year-old, 38% are men, 61% are women. Only 6% have no abnormality at the intrinsic capacity. Most often is vision and is often already known. Cognition for 56%, at least memory complaints. For hearing, 49%. Mouth, 36%, it may be related to the COVID, we don't know. Mobility, 33% have some kind of problem. And for malnutrition, 18%. Is the data that we got, and as I told you, 68% accept to participate to clinical research program. At the Gerontopole, we have some also ready-to-use cohort and biobank. We have the GIDAGE that was randomized control study in 2,800 subjects. We have the MAP study with 1,680 subjects, where we look at multi-domain intervention versus placebo versus no intervention group and placebo for omega-3. We have the Cockfrell study where we look 340 subjects that have both physical frailty and cognitive frailty, and we do follow-up and we look at brain imaging, amyloid PET scan, body composition to try to better understand what is cognitive frailty. We have the Nolan studies that was a preventive trial on memory decline in older adults. We have the SPRINT studies that will be published soon. That is a large trial to prevent sarcopenia and frailty related sarcopenia that was financed by the European Commission. We have the IPAD program on prodromal AD. We have the DUELS program that is also funded by the European Commission. When we look at the effect of aging on physical exercise, vitamin D plus omega-3. And we are working on the ANI program in the US, and we add omega-3 dosage in this population to look at the links with brain function. That is our INSPIRE invited program with some people that you must probably know, and we will be happy to have more links in the future with your institute. I learned about a lot about what you are doing in Chile, and we will be very happy to work together. INSPIRE long-term vision. Aging is complex and is the strongest risk factor for most chronic disease and dependency in late life. We believe it is modifiable. The catastrophic rise in healthcare cost is due to dependency. Demands we address the problem of aging. INSPIRE Institute is the first center in France to focus on basic science, translational geriatric clinical research, and care to society to prevent the consequences of aging. The impact of this project will be to reduce functional loss and dependency and contribute to the realization of our citizen desire to conduct an healthy, productive, and long-life society.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Bruno, for your very nice presentations.